Welcome to the presentation on Microsoft Edge accessibility. My name is Ann Taylor, and I am on the accessibility technical team. In this video, we will be sharing more about the accessibility features in Microsoft Edge. Microsoft's mission is to empower every person and every organization on the planet to achieve more, which inspires us to do more for our customers with disabilities. We also know that more than 1 billion people on the planet have a disability, which is why our team is committed to make Microsoft Edge more accessible. To do this, we test our browsers with customers with disabilities throughout the product life cycles, and their feedback informs future versions. While there is more to do, we are pleased to share new accessibility features to make web browsing easier and more enjoyable. Rory, over to you.
Thanks, Anne. As Anne mentioned, my name is Rory, and I'm a senior product manager on the Microsoft Edge team. You know, one of my main responsibilities is working with users with disabilities to make sure that Edge is accessible for all of our users. And that's why we work with users with disabilities early in the feature development process and consistently iterate based on the feedback. Today, I'll give you a quick overview of two new accessibility features in Microsoft Edge that were built in close collaboration with real users. The first feature I'll share with you today is called Page Colors. Page Colors allows users with sensitivity to bright colors or difficulty perceiving certain colors to specify a color scheme that will override the original colors on a web page. So for example, let's go to any web page. Let's say I had difficulty perceiving certain colors in this page. I can turn the feature on by going to the three-dot menu, selecting Settings, and selecting Accessibility. Here you'll find the Page Colors option. So I'll choose this drop-down menu here, and I'll select black. And notice all the colors on the settings page have changed. If I go back to the original tab, all the other colors have updated here too, with the black color scheme. I can also change the setting to a different color scheme. So for example, desert is a pleasant looking combination of brighter colors. And here's the result on the original page. Page Colors is expected to be available later this year, and we can't wait for you to try it out. Let's switch gears and talk about live captions, a feature that enterprise customers have been asking us for. Live captions analyzes the audio played in Microsoft Edge from, say, a video or a podcast for speech, transcribes that speech into text, and then displays that text in a separate window. One really cool thing about this feature is the entire process is done locally, so no audio or caption text ever leaves your device. You can enable live captions by navigating to the three-dot menu, selecting Settings, and then selecting Accessibility. Here you'll find the Live Captions Preview toggle. When I turn this feature on for the first time, it's going to download the language models needed for the Live Captions feature. Live Captions currently supports US English, though other languages will be added in the future. Once the download's complete, we can head over to any site with audio. So for example, I'll play this video.
At work, we're always looking for something.
And note that the caption window has actually appeared on screen in a separate window, and this is all happening real time on the device. The speech is detected in the audio and converted into text automatically in real time. The appearance of the caption window and text can be customized from Windows settings. For example, I can customize the text size, text color, and more, and these will be reflected in Microsoft Edge. Here I've selected large yellow text on a blue background, and when I flip back to Edge, the caption window reflects these customizations. Okay, that was a quick overview for two new accessibility features built into Edge. And with that, I'm going to throw it back over to Anne for more.
Thanks, Rory. My two new favorite features are instant answers and automatic image description, especially how they work with a screen reader like Narrator, the screen reader app that is built into Windows 11. Let's start with instant answers. Instant answers is a feature that provides answer to a certain type of queries directly in the address bar. So here I am in Microsoft Edge with narrative focus in the address bar. I can type the name of a landmark, maybe Space Needle.
F-A-X-A-E-E-E-L-E, space, Space Needle, Observation Tower, Bing Search, 1 of 9, selected.
Or I can type something like Seattle weather.
S-E-A-T-T-E-E-E-A. They're selected. Bing Search, Seattle weather. Answer, 22 degrees Celsius, sunny Seattle, United States, 1 of 9, selected.
This feature is an easy and fast way to get information and works great with Narrator. The second feature is auto-generated descriptions for users of screen readers. On the web, more than one half of the images processed by screen readers don't have text description. Also referred to as alternative text or alt text for short. When screen readers encounter an image that is missing a description, it usually sounds like this.
Image.
Thankfully, Microsoft Edge has a feature that uses Computer Vision API to analyze the images that are missing descriptions and generates alt text automatically. You can enable this feature by navigating to the three dots, Settings and More menu, choose Settings, then Accessibility. Here you'll find Toggle Setting, Get Image Descriptions from Microsoft for screen readers. So let's go back to that page and move the narrator focus to the image again.
Appears to be a person sitting in front of a wall of posters. Appears to say, Miriam Graham, Contoso's new chief marketing officer.
As narrator announced, the image was described, including the text in the image. While the quality of the descriptions can vary, it's better to provide some context for people using screen readers than none at all. While automatically generated alt text isn't a substitute for web developers adding their own, this feature can be a workaround if the page author hasn't added themselves. I love both of these features because they help me search the web more efficiently. At Microsoft, we value your feedback. Please do not hesitate to get in touch and share your feedback by navigating to the three-dot setting menus, then Help and Feedback, then Send Feedback. Alternatively, you can use Alt plus Shift plus I shortcut to send feedback. And together we can make Microsoft Edge work even better for you and for your organization. Check out the link in the video description for more resources about the accessibility features in Microsoft Edge. And on behalf of Rory and the Microsoft team, thank you very much for watching.